Hi, my name's Harry, and I'm a design engineer here at the bolt-tight division of the Nordlock Group. Today, we're going to be talking about the basic characteristics of a bolted joint. Firstly, let's take a spring to help demonstrate a bolt's functionality. As I extend the spring, it responds by trying to pull my hands back together. This compression represents the bolt's clamping force. So how does this occur? When an angular force is applied to the nut, the male and female threads push against each other. This reaction then forces the nut into the joint surface, which in turn stretches the bolt. The joint is then compressed as the bolt tries to return to its original length. As the name suggests, this clamping force is identical to that induced by a physical clamp. It's also important to note that a high percentage of load is lost due to friction. Therefore, even small variations in the thread and joint surface friction coefficients can significantly impact the retained axial load. Now, let's take a look at the internal behaviour of a bolt. A bolt's behaviour can be plotted in terms of its axial force and extension. During tightening, these two properties increase simultaneously. Hooke's law states that up to its elastic limit, a bolt acts elastically, simply meaning that the axial force is directly proportional to the extension. This relationship is essential for safely securing bolted joints. Not only is the behaviour predictable, but the bolt will return to its original length upon disassembly. However, if this safe working range is exceeded, permanent deformation will occur, eventually leading to failure. So there you go. I hope you enjoyed this explanation. Thank you for watching.